I'm StudyOnion, and this is a short video to introduce the GCSE Astronomy course. Over time, this channel will be used to upload videos for students to help them with learning GCSE subjects. Today, I'm going to introduce GCSE Astronomy, what the course contains, how you're assessed during the course, and most of all, some exam advice to top it all off. So, let's get started. Astronomy course is split evenly into two different sections. The first one is naked eye astronomy, and the second one is telescopic astronomy. Unit 1, which is naked eye astronomy, covers topic 1, planet Earth, topic 2, the lunar disk, topic 3, the Earth, Moon, and Sun system, topic 4, time and the Earth, Moon, Sun cycle, topic 5, solar system observation, topic 6, celestial observation, topic 7, the early models of the solar system, and topic 8, the planetary motion and gravity. And unit 2, telescopic astronomy, covers topic 9, exploring the moon, topic 10, solar astronomy, topic 11, exploring the solar system, topic 12, formation of planetary systems, topic 13, exploring starlight, topic 14, stellar evolution, topic 15, our place in the galaxy, and finally, topic 16, cosmology. I'll be making videos on each of these topics to explain more about them, and as I make them, they'll be linked to the playlists on my channel with each topic specifically curated as a playlist so you guys can find them quickly and easily for access for your revision. So let's talk about the assessment objectives. AO1, which is 40% of the course, is about demonstrating knowledge and understanding of scientific techniques, ideas, and procedures. AO2, which is 40% of the course again, is about applying that knowledge and understanding of the ideas, inquiry, techniques, and procedures. And finally, AO3, which is 20% of the course, is about analyzing information and ideas to interpret and evaluate, make judgments, and draw conclusions, as well as develop and improve experimental procedures. So, why do assessment objectives matter? Well, they matter because they tell us what the examiners are actually looking for. I'll make a detailed video explaining more about assessment objectives later and what they all mean, but just to quickly explain their significance, start out, let's look at AO3, for example. And this tells us that 20% of the astronomy exam spread out over both the papers will be on observations and experiments. So this is 40 marks out of the 200 is on observations. And there are about 16 of these that are vital for this course. And if you concentrate on learning the practicals, if you're stripped for time, that can really help you boost your grade quicker than learning all of the other information. Now, I'm not saying that you should do this. I'm not saying that you should cram. But if you are stripped for time, this is a really great use of your time. So, moving on to a little bit of exam advice. Each paper is broken down into 10 whole questions, which is, will have different parts, so AI, AIII, and so on and so forth. These will include, for each paper, 2 6-mark questions, which need a more extended and thorough, thoughtful response. What we are seeing is that, and what the exam board says, as well as what we have observed, is that the questions gradually increase in demand and difficulty through the whole paper. So the questions at the beginning will be easier than the questions at the end. This is why I recommend that you should go backwards throughout the paper. This means that as your energy level decreases, the difficulty of the questions also. Now, if you are struggling for time in these exams, the important thing is that you answer the questions at the beginning because those will be the easier marks to get. They will require less application and less challenging questions, which will make it easier for you to get the marks. So if you are struggling for time within the exam, make sure to answer the questions at the beginning. Getting that one mark at the beginning will be much easier than getting that one mark in a 6-mark question. Now, let's look for the 6-mark question. So, let's talk about the 6-marker. This is an example of a 6-marker question which shows you the importance of observations like I was talking about with the assessment objectives. Some naked eye drawings to illustrate the effect of libration. Design a suitable observing program that will allow the observer to produce a set a series of drawings that clearly show the effect of libration. So when we see this kind of question, we should really be looking at the kind of things that we should be thinking about with an observation. So some relevant points that they've suggested on the mark scheme are things like how many months, so like how long the observation should take place over. For example, for the shadow stick experiment, we're thinking about from 10 a.m. to like 2 a.m. approximately. For the libration experiment, maybe many months, that kind of thing. And why should we take, and we should also explain reasoning behind that. So if the observations to take place over many months, why is that? Because it's a gradual effect, it will take time to observe these slight changes. The next thing is that the observation should concentrate where. So for the moon, we're looking at the edges of the moon, things like the Tycho crater, the Sea of Crises, the Ocean of Storms, that type of thing. Maybe even the Copernicus crater, Kepler crater, to see what you can see just over the limbs of the moon. Also, which limbs should you be looking at to see what type of libration? So for libration in longitude, we're looking at the east and the west limb. And for libration in latitude, we're looking for the north and the south limb. And we also need to think about when you should observe the moon. So they're saying you need to observe the full moon when it's rising and setting to see diurnal libration, as it appears larger, so these features are a little bit easier to observe. And we also need to think about where. So the location is one of a moderate latitude, because you want the moon to be high in the sky. And we want to look at how assessment objectives contribute to this, right? So for zero marks, there is no rewardable material at all with this. For level one, they're talking about a plan, which should be attempted, but there's only limited analysis. And there are only general comments being made. The plan is also incomplete, and there's only basic information, and there's some linkages to the given context, so we should be talking about moon, libration, that type of thing. But this is incomplete, and there's not much clarity in this. Level two is there's occasional evidence of analysis of scientific information and ideas that attempts to synthesize and integrate the relevant knowledge. So here, basically, what they're saying is that there's an attempt at being relevant and including the relevant information, but there it isn't fully there. And it's adequate. And there is some link of these ideas with some structure, but it's not, again, it's not fully thorough. So level three is about a plan of the observational procedures, which is given, supported throughout by evidence. And now the key word here is throughout, because it has to be throughout the entire of the answer to the 6 marks question. And from the analysis of scientific information and ideas, and demonstrates the skills of synthesizing and integrating relevant information. So the knowledge that you're integrating has to be relevant, and it should be supported by evidence, and you have a plan that's clearly structured. So the plan is comprehensive and well-developed, a sustained line of scientific reasoning, which is clear, coherent, and logically structured. So again, that you're making sure that you're going from the beginning to the end, describing the method before you say how to perform repeats, and so on. So hopefully that acted as an introduction to GCSE astronomy, and I can't wait to see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys!